Hello, good morning everyone. Barrister Maria Banga here, founder of the association Hope for the Abused and the Battered. It's been a long while I did a live video strictly focused on the association and our work, especially with regards to the project AAF for internally displaced persons. That was a project, or that's a project, it's ending next month. That was geared towards raising awareness and advocating for the mental health rights of internally displaced persons. And something we had to do was identify some children of these persons who don't have ID cards, no, birth certificates, yes, and help in the facilitation of their birth certificates. I want to do a live video today because, well, I've just realized I cannot do this alone, and we don't have the funds. You know, when you get a grant, you don't have the full amount of whatever you want to do. They just give you a grant, and it is for you now to go and raise funds or do whatever you can to get money, you know, to complete. When you do a grant proposal, you have to say how much you are expecting from the donor and how much you yourself will bring in. So we were supposed to be doing some fundraising activities and all of that, but I'll be very honest with you, I'm not good at fundraising. I'm not good at asking for money. I've come a long way, but I still am not so good. So with this particular aspect of the project, I was really hoping we could just do it on our own. And I did not know we were going to have many children. I thought we'll have maybe a handful of children. I mean, a child's birth certificate, I just thought that, well, there's no way you give birth to a child and then that child will not have a birth certificate, especially when the law says before 3 months is free. But now, come to think of it, internally displaced persons, either you were displaced while you were already pregnant, or when you had the child, in some regions, people are not so prone to knowing what to do, where to go to do birth certificates and all of that. And then all of a sudden, there's the crisis and you are displaced. Or, well, there was a birth certificate and in the heat of the displacement, you could not find that birth certificate. What are you going to do? Keep struggling to find birth certificate or just go. Just go, go, go with your child, go. And then find yourself wherever you find yourself, in this case in Douala. And now the child has no birth certificate and so the child cannot be registered in school. And we have had children, even up to 7 years, who don't have birth certificates. This is really, really, really terrible. So now I want to tell you people that I have tried to get a waiver from the different services involved. If I can put my phone, you are going to see my table is full with documents. And I'm a lawyer, so I keep my things, and I want to read the different things I've been writing, all the different letters, right from November. What was it, even November, the very first one, 8th of Hello. December 2020. No, this is 8th of December. This is not even 2020.
Hello.
This was 2019. I don't know who was already in 2020 by that time. Anyway, so these are the list of the children from number 1 to number, what did I even say, 60, from number 1 to number 83. See, this is number 83 here. So I even said over 60 children. We actually have 83 children, and we are still, people are still calling, we are still identifying people. Well, so what can I tell you? So on the 8th of December 2019, I wrote to the governor, to the director general, sorry, of the, they call the office BINEC. On the 8th of December, the document was received by them on the 8th of January 2020. I don't know if it was January or December that I wrote this. Well, so I said, because somebody had told me that these people, if they call it what, Bureau National de l'État Civil. So that the kind of, I did not even know about that office. So that kind of this office that they are the ones in charge of civil status. So all civil status registration centers in the country are supposedly under their jurisdiction. So I thought that if you go and start from there, they can send instructions or information to all, like to Douala, for example, and say, please, this particular number, this case, and all of this, help them. We are working with them and facilitate the procedure for them, waive this certain amount of cost and all of that. So I wrote to the Director General. Look, I was even received by him, and he listened to me. And you know me, I write very politely and everything. So the man replied to me on the 14th of January, the Director General. This is the letter. He said, reference, yes, your letter of 30th December 2019, Proposition de Partenariat. Ahmed Marie Angela Banga, President de l'Association, blah, 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 blah. Fine. En accusant réception de votre lettre citée, j'ai l'honneur de vous faire connaître que j'apprécie à sa juste valeur l'intérêt que votre association porte à la question de l'état civil des personnes déplacées. Toutefois, je vous invite à prendre attache avec le comité ad hoc placé sous l'autorité du ministre de l'administration territoriale qui coordonne le plan gouvernemental d'assistance humanitaire d'urgence dans les régions du sud-ouest et du nord-ouest et qui a entre autres domaines d'intervention la reconstitution des documents individuels des déplacés internes. Veuillez agréer, madame, l'expression de ma considération distinguée. So, in brief, what he was saying is that, yes, madame, I've read your letter, but what you're doing is good, but it's not my office. Please, go to the Ministry of Territorial Administration. There's a particular service there in charge of.
Yes.
You know, Mina, I went to that service. This is the other letter. This letter is written 19 February. So when I got this on the 14th of January, blah, 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 I did letter, 19 February. Au comité ad hoc du plan gouvernemental d'assistance humanitaire d'urgence des régions du Sud-Ouest, ministère de l'administration territoriale, Yaoundé, Cameroun. I believe in Douala, I'm going to Yaoundé to do these things. I wanted to see, I wanted proof, and I wanted to see if I could get a government to take these things seriously. Because one of the things I am doing and what we do, activists, lawyers and everything, is to call things out and to say it and to say something is not right and we need to sit up. But in the meantime, what do? We keep doing the little we can do. Anyway, so I wrote to him and I said, Mr. Director General, we are coming towards you following the letter from Binet, la 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 la. And we want so, so, and so. Veuillez agréer, monsieur, l'expression de ma considération distinguée. Now, I wrote this letter on the, they received it on the 20th of February. Where is the reply from this man? This is it, 6th of April 2020. I followed this letter open. Now, I wrote on the 19th of February, they replied me on 6th of April 2020. They send the thing different services. What do they say? Madame la Présidente, la 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 la. Madame la Présidente, en accusant réception de votre correspondance citée en référence, j'ai l'honneur de vous faire connaître que mes services compétents ont pris acte de votre projet et pourront vous solliciter en tant que besoin. Aussi, je vous invite à vous rapprocher des services du gouverneur de la région du littoral pour le recensement des personnes déplacées internes en besoin de reconstitution de leurs documents d'état civil, en vue d'une éventuelle prise en compte de leurs doléances. So, this is it, 6th of April, 2020. They send me to the governor's office. Okay, oh. I write to the governor. I put all the files together, I write to the governor on the 8th of July, 2020. Demande d'appui technique pour les personnes déplacées internes, monsieur le gouverneur. Suite à la correspondance du ministre de l'administration territoriale, donc au 6 juin, nous venons auprès de vous solliciter. Even though the minister's letter put the governor in copy, I wanted to be sure I wanted to do it myself because if you're just sitting and waiting, nobody's going to call you. Now, I wrote to the governor. In the governor's office, they don't stamp on that thing. You have to buy a book. So I bought a book. Now, the letter was received on the 8th of July. And on the 29th of July, that is when they gave me a number for the file of the service to which that letter has been sent to. That is 29th of July. I sat here. I was like, ha. This school year is going to start. These children don't have birth certificates. How are they going to be registered in school? Let me better go to court because I know that after everything, we need a court declaration. And it's only the court that can issue that declaration. So while waiting for the governor's office to decide whatever they're deciding, let me go to court and find out if the court can help or what I can do in court. So I went to court. This is two files because the children were from Bonamusa under the Ndokoti jurisdiction and some were under the Bonaberry jurisdiction. So I had to do two files to go to two different courts. So one of the courts is Ndokoti court. There the president is a mother. So well, she tried to facilitate by telling me that, well, I could enroll the files. So you see, Apodi started paying to enroll the files there. In her jurisdiction, there are seven children. These are the demands I have done for those seven children. And you put fiscal stamp on them and all of those things. Fine. And then, because some of those children are not living with their parents in Douala, you know, some people say, you have to bring photocopy of this, you have to bring that, that, that. The children are, some are just here like that with guardians. You are struggling to eat. Where will you have money to be making birth certificate for the child? And look at how complicated the procedure is. How do you do it? So the president then said, okay, your association can sign on behalf of the parent of these children as long as the guardian gives you, thank you so much, Danny, the guardian gives you the authorization to do a birth certificate for them and they give you all the information that we need. That is what we were told in one court. In another court, this is Bonaberry. I wrote to the president. Because, you know, wait, there's something we call administrative law. I did administrative law. It is not just ordinary law like that. When you are dealing with the administration, you must be very formal. You must be very protocol. You must be all of that. So you don't just go to court and then start running your mouth. You go, you write to the president. The president will see it, will decide who in his service will address whatever you are writing about. And you put the state council in copy. You pay their own stamp duty. Then they give you the date to come back or they don't even give you a date. You have to keep going back to even just get the number of the transmission number. Because without the transmission number, nobody's going to tell you nothing about it. And I went to one office and there was no stamp. The stamp was for, you know, that long stamp. So I had to come back and come back and come back like 3 days in a row before they had a new stamp. Then when they stamp it, they will not give you the number there because the person who stamps it is different from the person who puts the numbers in some offices. So you just have to be patient, you know, like if you talk, what is the talk going to do to them? Anyway, so in Bonaberry, after I also registered the thing and I paid whatever has to be paid, they said, this is it. This is the chief of service to whom the president assigned the file. This is what he wrote. Certificat de non-inscription. You can get that from a council. Certificat dash apparent. You get that from a hospital. Each of these things, they told me, will cost 5,000. Photocopy signé de parent. That is the ID card of the parents. So imagine if parent is dead or parents are in some bush somewhere in the condo, wherever. How do you get a copy of their ID card? Some of them, their ID cards are expired or the ID cards got missing. So they did new ones. Those new ones have not come out. Even my son did his ID. This is the third time that whether they are renewing the recipe. Say the next one is to December 2020. Something he did sometime last year. Yes, yeah, so you need certificate de non-inscription. a certificate from a council showing that the child's birth has never been registered. It is supposed to be computerized. So we are supposed to know if that child was never, they never registered that child's birth. For the sake of this procedure, I have been advised that all of those children will be born in Douala. Because if they're not born in Douala, then Douala is not competent. I will have to go to where they were born. That one is out of the question. Because where they were born, you cannot go there. A child who was born in Banso, how do I go to Banso? A child who was born, I don't know, wherever, how do I go there? Okay. And then you need the photocopy of two witnesses. Photocopy of the ID card of two witnesses. Photocopy of the ID card of their parents, two witnesses. You need a stamped application. And you need to enroll it in court like this, 3,000 francs per file. So now they told me that there's a mayor in a certain council somewhere who has got a soft heart for these people. You know, when you're helping them, you have a soft heart. So I went and saw this mayor. That mayor, he's a legit mayor. And because he's a mayor, he has gathered some before and gone and done the procedure himself, gone to the council where he himself is council. He will do the certificate and non-inscription. Then gone to the hospital. There they can do certificate, the ash apparent. Because if the child does not have a birth certificate and the child does not have a hospital declaration, you cannot say that this child is eight. What proves that the child is eight? Only an administrative document can prove that the child looks like 8 years. Even you, the mother, you can also say that I delivered this child on the 20th of January 2014. No, a hospital is the one to certify from a public hospital, government hospital. For example, Bonaberry, you go to Bonasama. In the Dokoti area, you go to district, the Bonamusadi or Cité de Pamier or Lokbaba, one of those places. Yes, my dear, it is complicated. So when I got this mayor who said he can do all of those things for 10K per child, I was like, this is the best deal we can have. And the mayor said he is going to issue an invoice. I don't think that he wants to lose his job for that kind of a thing. I am a lawyer. So yes, we are going to do this and he's going to do that. So that is where we are right now. So if anybody wants to help, even one child, you will have done something. Because just imagine, the child will be able to go to school. And you know, education, no matter what we say about it, our system in Cameroon, that is the platform, that is the base. Let's at least allow children, give each child the possibility of going to primary education. I hear that the fee, you don't pay to go to primary school in Cameroon, but if you have to go through all of this to get birth certificate, have you already paid? So just imagine now these children. They don't have birth certificate. Some are even up to how many years? Let me look at that list again. So this is the form that the parents filled, according to what the man said. So the name, the surname, the date of birth, place of birth, father's name, father's date of birth and place of birth, the profession, place of residence, nationality, mother's name, mother's date of birth, profession, place of residence, nationality. I don't know whether we need all of that information per se, but that is it. So far we have some parents and guardians are coming here, you know, and they're filling forms. These are forms that are filling, as you can see. But many of the forms, to be honest, out of 10 forms, or is it 10 or 15 forms so far, only one has a valid ID card. The other ones, the receipts have expired. So I don't even know if by the time we get there, they will say, oh, the receipts have expired, so they have to go and renew it. That's another procedure altogether. You know, sometimes you want to help the IDPs, you're just providing food, For me, it's like, yeah. But now, what about the children? What about their education? Are we encouraging them to stay out of school or to just continue being, I don't know. Oh, my goodness. So, these are the children here. 6, 4, 4, 1, 6, 3, 7, 1. The oldest is 7. We have a 1 month and we have a 3 months. At least the 1 month and 2 months and 3 months, we can do it directly from the council. We don't need that, but there are just about three of them who are 1 month. It's another about three, okay. 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. After that, we have a 19 months, 15 months. That was at the time when we did this thing in last month or so. So this is it. 3 pages. I said over 60. We have 83. 83 children. Let's see how many we can help, right? I mean, it gives me goose pimple because I'm like, oh. I don't want to get into politics. I don't know if it was worth it. The children are the ones suffering a lot of. Okay, so if you want to help, you want to join us to help these children. I mean, 10K, sometimes to be honest, even me myself, I can spend 10K in a day or even for a meal, you know, for something, for a massage. But I personally am going to sponsor the birth certificates for 3 children. I want to do that personally. You can support us through mobile money. I have a very dear big sister in America, Veronica Fortu. She has opted to collect for those out there who want to support. 10K is what this mayor has asked for each child. But you know, the cost of running up and down, the whatsoever. So yeah, our budget is 600. Is it 600K anymore? It's 830K. But I don't know what to say. I really don't know. I would have come to you people earlier on, but I was hoping I would not have to find myself in this situation. But I just realized I cannot do this. I can't. So let me come out. If I've asked people for skipping rope and they have provided skipping rope for me, then let me ask for more serious things. Let's do this. Let's do birth certificates for the children so they can at least go to primary school. Because at 7 years, are you going to send that child to nursery school again? Which child is going to nursery school again? Just primary education. And then our website is there. You can donate on our contact page. The mobile money is for the association itself, so it's not my mobile money. So the name there is Hope for the Abused and the Battered. So if you are sending your money there, the phone is not even with me, it's with my assistant. So you may want to call and confirm somebody else is going to pick, not me necessarily. But I really want to really appreciate all those who are going to help. I just realized that the numbers are not 60 but 83. Okay, well, so let's do this for our children. If government is not picking this thing up or taking it as seriously as they should, or I don't know, well, we civil society organizations, I think one of the things we have to do is mobilize community support. Let's do this. If each person sponsors only one child and we are 83 of us, that means all of those 83 children will have a birth certificate by God's grace before school resumes. And if I take 3 and one person decides to take 2 or 5, can you imagine? We are going to help all of them until we might even be able to offer them books and pens. Why not? So let's at least first get the birth certificates. And then when we know they're going to school, we might now do a back to school package for these children. I cannot imagine some of them have not been to school for like, since 2016 or 2017. Thank you so much, darling. Thank you, everybody. Yeah, I'm an emotional person, you know, and That is it. Whew, Father. Thank you, all angels on our path. Thank you, all those who are going to reach out. Thank you so much. I want to be able to come back here in October with all of these birth certificates. Of course, we'll do a ceremony. We'll do, I mean, oh my goodness. Can you imagine parents coming here to pick up their child's birth certificate or picking it up directly from the council and we doing a whole, oh my goodness, Father, may this come to pass. And so if you sow that kind of a seed in the life of a child, can you imagine what you have done to one child? Giving them the opportunity to just go to school, to at least have a birth certificate. Okay, well, to God be the glory. Great things he has done. I appreciate you all. Please, anybody who wants to share, kindly share, you know. Let's get this far and wide. All I want to do is help them. All I want to do is help these children. Let the children have birth certificates. That's all I want to do. Their parents can continue struggling with their ID cards, you know, but for me, it is the children. Okay, thank you so much, everybody. Happy Tuesday. God bless us all.